So our three problems are so closely related that either all of them lie here in NP, but not in P, or all of them lie in P. We don't know which one it is, but it can't be the case that, for example, we have just vertex cover in P and the other two problems here in NP. And how did we show that in the last unit? For click and independent set, we showed that there was a polynomial time algorithm that could take a graph that was an input to independent set and transform that into a graph that we can use in, as an input for click. And once we have solved the click problem on the transformed graph, that same solution is also the best possible solution to independent set. So we have a polynomial time algorithm. So the algorithm transforms the input of one problem, say x, into an input of another problem, y. So for example, we take independent set and transform that graph into an input for click. And now you'll see one of the advantages of working with decision problems, because the third condition is rather easy to state, because we can now simply say that solving the problem y on the transformed input yields the same answer as solving the original problem on the original input. So these three statements here are the same thing that you have seen in the last unit. So we took an input, which was a graph to independent set, then transformed it into an input for click, and we found out if we solved click on that new input, then we would get the same answer that we would have gotten if we had solved independent set directly on the original input. And of course, we also saw that the transformation worked in the other way. So we could transform an input to click into an input of independent set. And now for vertex cover and independent set, it was even easier because we didn't even have to transform the input. So basically the transformation was we could keep the input as it is. The only thing is if we're working with a decision problem, of course, the answer will be a little bit different. So if we have a vertex cover of size k for a graph with n vertices, then for independent set, we must ask if we have an independent set of size n minus k. But other than that, the transformation here is very easy.